guys. How's it going? We're going to take a look at this tile pattern right now. Now, I really like the problems like this. These tile pattern ones are really good because they show you the power of algebra. What algebra is really, really good at doing is describing patterns, right? Which we have right in front of us, patterns here, but specifically describing the change, right? Algebra is good for describing the change of patterns. And that's like a whole kind of theme this course. What is change? How do I describe it? And how do I describe it effectively and concisely? Answer a question like number three here really quickly, okay? So you're watching this video because maybe you haven't done too many tile pattern stuff in the past. You want to get a little more insight, hear a little bit more detail step-by-step. I'm going to break down step-by-step for you how to do problems like these so that you can do your exit ticket and know and feel confident about doing this in the future, okay? So if you did today's assignment and went smoothly, you're like, I've done this a million times in the past, good to go. Cool, you're good to go. You don't need to watch this video, just do your exit ticket. If not, right, this video exists and you can always request videos like this if you want to, okay? So let's go through it and I'll break down with you step by step. It says here, right, in a problem like this, just like in your exit ticket, it says for each pattern, describe how the pattern is growing. Draw in the diagram to help you describe what you notice. Shade, circle, draw arrows, etc. Okay? So we notice here that the pattern, right, because there's a pattern, right, and it's changing, none of these are the same, right? None of these are the same. So we need to figure out by what pattern Z is changing or by what change is happening here. Okay? Step one, recommendation. I know this can be hard just kind of eyeballing it, being like, oh, I can't figure it out. I can't figure out how this is changing. So what you need to do is to get your feet wet. Right? You need to get your feet wet by diving in there and marking up the diagrams, right? Drawing down, filling up with color however you can, right? If that's sketching it out on your own and kind of filling it up, you're good to go. So what I would do, step one, is to outline the original figure you have, or at least the lowest figure you have. The lowest figure we have here is figure one. So it's not actually what this pattern starts with. The thing that the pattern starts with is figure zero, right? Figure zero. In math, at starting, is you start at time zero or place zero, and then you add on from there, okay? So this is figure one, it's not figure zero, but it's a sort of our beginning, okay? So I outline that as my step one, outline the first figure, then find that figure in the second figure here. And I notice that I have this little jagged edge over here, so I'm gonna try to outline a figure that was exactly like that. So I gotta go up two here, over one, and it looks like I have this kind of one, two, three thing here on top. So I'm gonna outline this. Okay, good. So I have this figure, that figure there, they match each other. That's good because now I notice here, I have two left over up top here. So I'm gonna shade this in a different color because I'm gonna get back to this later. I have these two tiles here, okay? So going from figure one to figure two, my diagram got two tiles bigger. Let's see if that's consistent. Let's see if that sticks around in figure three. And we also have two more tiles being added on here. Let's check it out. Well, now, right? So my figure is now over with these two over here. So what I'm doing, what I recommend doing here is finding this figure, this thing in figure two, find it in figure three. Because the idea is you're just adding on these tile patterns. You're adding on to a particular design a certain amount. So if I can find this over here, and it looks like I actually have it here to the left side, is again where I have that kind of jagged left edge, and I come back around, and now I have these two up here on top, and boom, look at this. I have figure two, I found it over here. How many more? How was the change as I went from figure two to figure three? Oh, we have two more tiles there, so I'm gonna go ahead and shade that in. And once again, going from one figure to the next figure, we've gotten two tiles bigger. And it looks like my change is being consistent. So we have a pattern and we're gonna use this to make predictions about what figure 100 looks like and what figure zero must look like in a second here. So by shading and by using arrows, we can describe the pattern here. And I'm gonna do that in words right now. Each time my figure number goes up by two, figure number goes up by one, the amount of tiles go up by two. All right, number two, draw in figure zero and figure 100, how many tiles are in each of these? The easier thing of these two between figuring out figure zero and figure 100 is gonna be figure zero. And that's actually the more important one. That'll be important for number three here. But anyways, getting the figure zero, that's also known as the starting figure, which you start out with, okay? So this was figure one, this isn't the original figure. What's more important to us is getting the original figure here, figure zero. So if we're going plus two, so every time figures get bigger, right? What this pattern is showing us here is that we're adding two tiles to it when the figure number goes up by one. So then the question is, when the figure number goes down by one, when the figure number, instead of going up by one, goes down by one, what does that mean about number of tiles? Well, the opposite is going to be true, because if we're adding two on in kind of the top right, right, that's how the right, the column here, to the top of the right column here, that means this here, figure zero, would have two fewer tiles in it than figure one. And it looks like the ones we're gonna have to get rid of, it looks, so notice here that that we're always adding to the right column when the figure numbers are getting bigger. So that means over here, those are the two that we need to get rid of to draw the original figure number zero. So I'm gonna do that in blue because that's what I've been tracing my colors in here. So we still have the three on top of one another, and we have the one on the left, but the right column here, right? These would be our first two original tiles right here. So I might change that number, right? Starting with figure number zero, there were four in figure number zero. We'll come back to that later. We add on two greens here, and then another two greens for figure two, and then another two greens for figure three. And that's how our tile pattern appears to be growing. And we got our first four here, and we're good to go. All right, figure 100 here. We need to draw that one in. Okay, so this here, where again? So when you're picking up these problems, you're trying to observe, where are my tiles being added, okay? And what do I know is always going to be there? So figure 100, we're not gonna be able to draw this whole thing in because, wait a second, that's gonna be a ton of tiles, huge amount of tiles here. So what we need to do is to draw a diagram sort of describing what this is going to look like here, okay? First of all, what do we know is going to be in that? Well, we would know that we're gonna have these tiles here, right? Those tiles here, which is the original four tiles, okay? We know we have the original four. So notice this here, in all these figures, we have this 1, 2, 3, 4 here, 1, 2, 3, 4 here, and then the 1, 2, 3, 4 here. And sort of that right column is where our change tiles are. So that's gonna help us figure out what figure 100 looks like here, because we know that figure 100 is going to have the original four tiles here on the left side. 1, 2, 3, and another one makes four here, okay? So then the question becomes, exactly how big is this right column, right? This right column right here. And in figure zero, there was nothing in the right column, nothing in the right column. Figure one, there was two in the right column. Figure two, how many are in the right column in total? There were four in the right column. Figure three, how many were in the right column? There were six in the right column. So here, what are you noticing about the right column? These are kind of the observations you'll have to make to kind of like do problems like these. So again, let me repeat myself. Zero, figure zero has zero in the right column. Figure one has two in the right column. Figure two has four in the right column. Figure three has six in the right column here. How do those numbers relate? One times what is two? Two times what is four? Three times what is six? Again, what? Times two. Times two. So figure 100 would have 50 in the column. Oh no, not 50 in the column. Figure 100 would have, what's times two? Would be 200 in the right column here. So that's what you're drawing out. That's what you would sketch out here to show us that you'd have an idea of what this would look like here. We would have 200 total. And again, this is just a diagram. You're just describing kind of what it would look like, giving a representation over here. So you'd have 204 total tiles in figure number 100. Again, how is this pattern changing? How is it changing? It's every single time figure number goes up by one, the number of tiles goes up by two. Well, it happened 100 times. So if there are 100 changes and two tiles each time, that means you've added on 200 tiles to the right column right there. Number three, describe in words or an equation how you might find the total number of tiles in any pile. What if we asked you to find figure number 73? So what I think the thing might be more helpful and what we might be looking for, so I kind of already did number two here, we've done number one, we're on number three right now. What would be more helpful for you guys is to maybe talk about the equation here. So an equation means a statement of equality, right? Equality, where we're trying to figure out in an equation the total number of tiles, okay? So I'm gonna do total number of tiles here. And we want to determine it for any pile number or any figure number. And it says here, figure number 73. So think about it, right? Think about it for a second. I think you could reason through something like this. For instance, right, figure number 100, we knew it would have 200 here and four there because how many times have we changed? Well, we've changed 100 times and we've changed by 200 times. So there's this idea of multiplication here, 2 times 100 is 200. And then we had what over here? We had the original 4. So anyways, let me try to simplify this a little bit here. When you're trying to come up with the equation, okay, when you're trying to come up with the equation, start by actually writing this here. Write the number tiles that are in figure number 0. And I'm going to put that over here, okay? This is 4 right here. So total number of tiles, I know there are going to be at least 4 in each one because that's how many tiles the pattern start with, okay? The pattern starts with. So figure 0 has 4 tiles. So we start with this. Put the 4 in here. And this is called what? For those of you who studied this in middle school before, putting 4 in equation here, I'm doing that because this is figure number 0. And 4 is the starting value, okay? So your starting value does appear in an equation like this. It does appear in an equation like this. And oftentimes, right, pretty much all year, your starting values are going to appear in your equation. So you're going to have to kind of find them here, okay? So 4 is in our equation here. And remember that we're trying to find the total number of tiles based on a particular figure number. So for a given, and I'm going to put this in parentheses here, for a given figure number, we wouldn't just take the figure number, right? So here, figure number here is 3. We wouldn't just add 4 to that because 3 plus 4 is 7. And here we have more than 7 tiles. Look at this. We have 4 tiles here, and then we have another 6. We have 16 tiles. Sorry, 4 and then another 6 is 10 tiles, not 7 tiles here. So we take our figure number. What do we have to do to the figure number? Well, this is 200 here. So we had the original 4, right? Here's our 4. And here's our 200 right here, because how do we get that 200? We did 2 times by the figure number, right? Times by the figure number, and that's what equals the 200 here, okay? So the change number goes right here, okay? So a couple of vocabulary words I'm sharing with you. Starting value, end of the equation, right? You add the starting value to whatever the change number, this is change number right here, and you multiply it by the figure number. So 2 times whatever the figure number is plus 4 tells you how many tiles will be in a particular figure number here. So what if we asked you to find figure number 73? Let's plug this in to see if you kind of got that one. So total number of tiles in figure number 73. And that's going to equal 2 times by the figure number, which is 73. Because we would have in the right side here, the right column, we would have 2 tiles for every 73 of the figure number. So 2, so this is, remember, this is 3 times 2 is 6. We'd have 6 here. We'd have 2 times 73 in the right column. And then on the left side, right, we have in all of these, right, all these figures, we have our starting 4, right? Can't forget about the starting 4 in any of these, so I got to add 4 here. Okay, so figure number 73 would have 2 times by 73. So 2 times 70 is 140. 2 times 3 is 6. So that would be 146 plus 4. And I would have 150 tiles in figure number 73. Figure number 73. So you might be wondering, is there actually an easier way to write this equation? Because this is pretty messy. Look what I wrote up here. This is pretty messy. Because for equations that you guys have probably seen in the past before, you've probably used, instead of writing out words like this, what have you done? What have you done? Has it been words or has it just been a particular letter? Yeah, it's been a particular letter, right? So it's usually we represent words in terms of variables. Total number of tiles, well, we don't know what figure number we're talking about, so we'll give that one a variable. So usually, right, writing this out as an equation, the total number of tiles is your dependent variable, right? That depends on what the figure number is and how it's changing. So that's going to get y as the variable. So y equals 2x, okay? So we can let the figure number be x. So y equals 2 times by x because that's the figure number. So figure number gets x. Total number of tires gets Y, and we have our starting number on the side here, okay? So what this would represent, this might be a little bit too advanced for you guys for right now, but we'll get it into this when we get into the real algebra in a few weeks. The equation that would be written up like here, and it would look more like that, like this here, right? This is our equation for this situation where Y is the total number of tiles and X is the figure number here. Y equals 2X plus 4. All right, so you did class today. You may have watched that video and you might have been like, Mr. Fortin, that was way too fast. That was way too much. That just means we need to practice once more. Okay, so just really quickly here, I do have another example because I think we can go through it very quickly and maybe it'll be a little bit less overwhelming if we just do it together real quick based on the rules that I just told you guys. So you can kind of get it real quick and you can get it down and then give the next one a shot on your own and then also give the exit ticket a shot. And also too, ask questions. If it's still not making sense, I can meet with you in person here, okay? First one here, all right? So again, same directions. We got a new pattern, pattern W. Describe how it's changing. I'm going to outline the outside. So we have four right here. That's not in figure zero, but it's in figure two right now. We have four here. So I think we're gonna go down here. Look, we go down here. And that means I gotta go one over and then one over here. And I have it outlined. So this one here appears, if it is growing consistently, appears to be growing with one down below, one up top, and one to the left, okay? And I have that here as potentially growing by three, okay? So let's see if we can find this shape here on this side to see if going from figure two to figure three also got bigger by three tiles in total. Here, I have one on the right, okay? So that's sort of where I can kind of find, because I only have one to the right of a stack of four. So I need to go up one, and I need to go down by two, and it looks like actually I have one new one here, one new one down here. That's good. That matches this one here, sort of mirrors that one right here. And now I got to go two over. So again, I'm tracing the big size, right? I'm tracing the big one because I'm going from figure two to figure three. So that means I got to go two over here, and we're good to go. So we're picking up this piece up here, this tile here, and this tile below, and this tile to the left. Okay, describe how the pattern's growing. I'm gonna use arrows. Going from figure one to figure two, we're getting bigger by three. Going from figure two to figure three, we're getting bigger by three. We got one here, here, and here, 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 and here. The pattern is growing consistently, and it's growing by plus three. All right, so if we're going by plus three this direction, where our figure numbers are getting bigger by plus one, if our figure number gets smaller by one, that means we're going to lose three tiles, okay? Where are the three tiles gonna lose for? Well, it's gonna be lost here, here, and ooh, up top. Ooh, that's actually tricky. It's gonna be lost here too. So notice this column here is where we get two new ones here at top and bottom, two new ones here at top and bottom, so that means we're losing these two, right? These two as we go from down here and also the left side. Okay, so that means that this is gonna be the only one remaining when we get down to figure number zero. All right, we only have one here as our starting number, okay? That's figure zero. What about figure number 100? Well, figure number 100, let's start with that one that's on the right side. Notice here, this is our starting tile in this figure, and this figure here. So start by drawing your starting figure, which is this right here, and then you need to describe how it would have changed. And it's changing 100 times because it's figure number 100. Okay, so for each new change, we add on one up top here. So we would, if we did it at 100 times, we would have 100 pieces above that, not above that original one. It actually would have been right here. We would have 100 up here, okay, starting at pretty much level here, all the way to the top, this would be 100 right here. Okay, 100 starting there, going up, and also starting at the beginning here, look, we added one to the left here below, and we've already talked about here, the 100 up top, we'd add 100 below that, okay, 100 below that as well, kind of where I'm pictured in this video. Down another 100. And this is a big figure, and we've grown up top here, we've grown down below, and we've also gonna grow this way because we haven't talked about growing to the left. Every single time we get one to the left, and that's happened 100 times, okay? So if we've grown by 100 up top, 100 down below, and 100 to the left, we've grown by 300 total, okay? So again, figure 100, and we've had three new tiles each time means a total change of 300, and we would have 301. Tiles in figure 100 right there. Finally, describe in words or an equation how to find the total number of tiles in any pile. So I'm gonna use our equations, I'm gonna use the letters here, just get used to using Y and X here, okay? So remember that Y is the number of tiles. The number of tiles is determined by what figure number it is, because we're going to have some change that we're going to think of. We also have a starting number too. And so X is the figure number. To write your equation, right? To write your equation to figure out how many there are in 73, we got to start with, well, if X were zero, right? Figure number is zero. Figure number was zero. We would still have one here. Okay, one here. So here we have our starting number on the left side. And for a figure number of 73, how much would we have to multiply to 73? We'd have 73 different changes. And each time, how many changes? How many more do we get each change? Well, we got three each time. Repeat, if we're adding three 73 times, adding three 73 times, what's an easy way we can add three 73 times? It's not just adding again and again and again. So repeated addition is what? Multiplication. So multiplication is shorthand for repeated addition. So that means we put a three in front of this here. Okay. And just to double check that we got our answer correct and it makes sense, let's test that out for figure 73. Let's figure out how many tiles it has here. So let's solve for Y. Y is the number of tiles. And we're going to take three because we get three new ones each new figure. And if we're getting to the 73rd figure, that means it would have changed 73 times from the original figure. And we'll add one to it right here. And this is where Mr. Fortin, right, is going to tell you, hey, use your calculator, right? Three times 73. You can do that in your head. I trust you can do that in your head. But save that brain power for other stuff here. Just use your calculator and get this, right? What is it, 219? Let's see. You do it in your head, double check it in your calculator, get good to go. Yes, there's 219. So this becomes 219, and we add our one to it, and that would mean that we would have 220 tiles in figure number 73. And then to double check you got the equation correctly right here, you might want to ask, does that answer make sense? Well, figure number 73 having 220, how many did figure 100 have? Well, figure 100 had 301, which is still more, right? You expect more because we're getting three new ones each time. So I would say yes, figure number 73 totally makes sense. Went through it a second time right there. Went through a little bit more quickly. You might be like, still overwhelmed, not sure. Go back, rewatch this video, right? Rewatch the video, slow it down. And again, I can meet with you if you're still having trouble. Before I meet with you, so go back, rewatch it if you need to. Before I meet with you, I'm going to sign off right now. I'm going to give you one more problem, okay, that you can do kind of on your own. Here is pattern T. So maybe sit back, pause the video. Just think about it, right? Give it a shot on your own. Give it 5-10 minutes of work. If you're having trouble, watch the video, the rest of the video, so you see how I solve it. And if you do it and you want to make sure you got it correctly, continue watching the video and you'll be able to see if you got it correct. See that you got it right. Okay? That's it for me. Hopefully you enjoy kind of doing these pattern type problems, and it's going to get us into new, better, more interesting conversations. Thanks, guys. Make sure you reach out if you have questions. Bye.